Good morning everyone. Today I am going to explain you the topic is sex ratio. This is the second topic. In the previous class I was explained you about the census show and about the A structure. Today I am going to explain you about the sex ratio, the number of males or the number of females, availability per 1000 males in the population, we have known as the sex ratio. This is the gender difference. The difference between the male and female we have find out by the sex ratio. So the number of females, availability per 1000 males in the population, we have known as the sex ratio. So this is the important social indicator. So this is the very important social indicator through which we can find out the difference between the male and the female. So we can notice that in India we have found the number of males lower than compared to male in India. So and also we have found the discrimination between the men and women. So the women and girls are getting the less benefits, and also women and girls are getting unequal opportunities in education and also in the development in the society, in the development places. So the women and girls are discriminating in various places, such as in the girls are not providing the proper nutrition food compared to boys, and also not providing good education compared to boys. So there is no the healthcare facilities. There is no good healthcare facilities for women compared to male, and also there is no good the facilities for child babies, the female babies, the child care centers. There is no proper child care centers, child care facilities, not providing good child care facilities for female babies compared to male babies. So there are much differences we have found in India in between the male and female. So according to the census, according to the medical survey, according to the medical research shows that girl children given similar circumstances, the girl children has much better survive compared to male. Actually the girl children has much better survive compared to male child. Even though we have found the number of girls lower compared to boys. So another census also showing that the female birth rate, female baby's birth rate is higher than the male babies. So for example, you see the another survey is showing that 103 female babies are born against the 100 male babies. 103 female babies are born against the 100 male babies. It means the birth rate of the female babies higher compared to male babies. So then also if there is no discrimination in the society, then the number, the female babies, the male number, the female number is higher than compared to male, compared to male. But we have found the number of females were lower compared to male. It means there is the bias in between the girl and boys in our society. So and also we have found the years 0 to 5 years aged, the girls were we have found the less number of the aged girls less survival compared to boys. So the years 0 to 5 years aged, the girls less surviving compared to boys. So like that, the number of deaths also high in female babies compared to boys. So like that, we have found the bias in between the girls and boys in India. So here one table given in our textbook, according to that table, the area, the Haryana, when we have found the Haryana, the sex ratio is 879. So in Punjab 895. So in Andhra Pradesh 993. Kerala 1034. So the number of females 1034 are there in Kerala, compared to the 1000 males, compared to 1000 males. This means the Kerala having the positive sex ratio compared to other states. Kerala having positive sex ratio. In Kerala, we have found the 1034 female, the number of females when compared to males, 1000 males. So this is the positive sex ratio we have found in Kerala. In America also, there is no much bias in between the girls and boys. So positive sex ratio we have found in America. So 1050 female, the number of females are availability compared to 1000 males in America. So in Andhra Pradesh also is a little bit better compared to other states. In Andhra Pradesh still some bias is there. There are the females 993 females availability compared to 1000 male in Andhra Pradesh. In Punjab and Haryana, there is a very, they are showing much differences. There is the, we have not found the positive sex ratio in Haryana and Punjab. In other states like Uttar Pradesh, Bihar and Madhya Pradesh, Rajasthan, Orissa, these places, in particularly in these the states, they are showing much variation in between the girls and boys. They are giving more priority to boys and males in Haryana, Punjab, Madhya Pradesh, Uttar Pradesh, and the other place. Those states. So that's why. What are the reasons behind why they are showing? Because the in these states, particularly in Haryana, Punjab, Madhya Pradesh, and Uttar Pradesh, in these states, the people are the families are giving more important to male babies compared to females. So they feel that the female are burden for the family. So in Haryana and Punjab, they feel that the females are burden for the family. And also some religious some religion customs, and some due to the social norms. So they are giving more important to male babies. And also we have found higher mortality rates of girls. We have found in these states, particularly Haryana and Punjab and Odisha, Uttar Pradesh, we have found the higher mortality rate. Higher mortality rate of girls compared to boys. And female fetus infanticide. Female fetus infanticide means they found the female before birth, they are killing the female babies. Before birth, they are killing the female babies. And we have found higher mortality rates of girls compared to boys, and also we have found female fetus infanticide particularly in Haryana and Punjab, Uttar Pradesh and Madhya Pradesh, Odisha and Bihar, and those states we have found the female fetus infanticide. So this is about the sex ratio. So in our India we have found much differences and not giving much priority to female compared to boys. So now we are going to another topic, that is the literacy rate. So literacy rate, what is the literacy rate? Means the person 70 years and above who has able to read and write in any language and understand the language is known as the literacy, literate. What is a literate? What is a literacy? Means a person can have a person 7 years and above can have able to read and write in any language and can understand the language is known as the literate. So literacy rate is very low at the time of independence in 1947. We have found 12% of the literacy rate only. 12% of the literacy rate after 2001. After 2001, we have found 64.84%. 64.84% of the literacy rate we have found in 2001. Next, in 2011, we have found 74.04% of the literacy rate in India. So, at the time of independence, 12%. In 2001, 64.84% of the literacy rate. Then in 2011, we have found 74.4% of the literacy rate. This is not sufficient to the country in Sri Lanka. Sri Lanka is one of the small island country. South side of India, it is achieved more than 90% of the literacy rate. So it is very essential now present as more than 90% of the literacy rate is essential for the country development. So we have found less literacy rate in India. We have found only the 74.4% according to the 2011 census. According to the 2011 census, so among the literacy rate we have found the bias in between the male and female. So the male educated have found more number compared to female. So the female education, the female number is 65% and the male we have found the male literacy rate we have found 82.14%. Male literates are 82.14% compared to female 65.46%. So like that we have found the bias in education or in the literacy also, in literacy rate. Within the literacy rate also, there is the difference between the girls and boys. Girls are getting less education compared to boys. Boys are more numbers, 82.14%. Boys, the male are literate compared to female, only 65%. 65% only female get the literate. So this is about the sex ratio and literate. Thank you children. Please subscribe my channel and click like button.